In this part of Brazil's impoverished northeast, known as the sertão, the backwoods, the land is dry and rain scarce for most of the year. Not many crops thrive in these conditions. But manioc, also known as cassava, will grow here, and most small farmers cultivate it to make starch and flour, a staple food ingredient for many people in this region. There is also lots of strong and constant wind, and such wind has become a source of energy for the country and income for hundreds of families here who are paid rental for the use of their land for wind turbines.
Some landowners here with larger areas have up to a dozen turbines set up in their properties, and that does give them some good rental money. But the biggest impact we see here is in the lives of smaller farmers, usually poorer ones, who have space for one or two turbines. For them, the extra money can make a big difference.
José Valdecir da Silva has two of these turbines set up on his land. The company that owns them pays the equivalent of about $400 per month for each one.
Teve gente que arrendou e outros não arrendaram.
Some of the people decided to lease their lands and others didn't. Those who didn't now regret it because they're not getting the money. For us who did it, it's good. It's not a whole lot of money, but it's very helpful now because manioc prices are very low.
The Ventos do Araripe Wind Energy Park was built by Brazilian company Casa dos Ventos and completed in 2017. It was partially funded with resources from the China-based New Development Bank, the NDB, also called the BRICS Bank. That NDB funding here in Ventos do Araripe came to about $67 million out of a total of $621 million allocated by the bank for projects across Brazil between 2016 and 2018.
Important to have the support of NDB, not only as a financial standpoint enhance our capability for the project, but also they bring a lot of experience on structuring these kinds of projects.
The mayor of the 14,000 inhabitants town of Simões, where most of the park's turbines are located, says the 300 towers set up in their territory make a big difference for the city.
The wind park has certainly helped the farmers around here because they receive an income from the use of their land. And this income also helps to boost the local economy and benefits all citizens.
There are many opportunities for investment in infrastructure in Brazil, including those with great potential to improve people's lives. Brazilians will no doubt continue to look to international institutions like the New Development Bank to help make these projects a reality. Paulo Cabral, CGTN, Simões, in Brazil.